like to request Kamya Anantakrishnan, senior journalist, to say a few words.
I stand here as one among hundreds and probably thousands of students and young professionals whose life he has touched both professionally and personally. And the last 1 week there's been several flashes of memories. I just want to share a couple of those memories. Remember, as joining here when I was 22 and maybe probably in a very junior position, lowest in the rung in this institute, he always used to have time for me and he and I think several other of the students. We used to stand in a line outside his room and we come with some very silly problems now we can imagine, but he used to take time, sit and solve it and really help us to think ahead and think bigger. And that was, he was never perturbed and he was always there for us. And for us, he was like a father figure, because we do spend a lot of time in our career, in the office and in the institute, and he was the father figure to us here. And another flash of memory is, we wrote the first paper, I remember, and the comments had come and we had to actually write the response to the comments, and Dr. Nani and myself, we didn't know how to do it at all. And so we came here and I wanted to babysit my son, 6 months old. So I brought him also and he quickly cleaned his desk and made him sit there. Aunt Julia, come sit on my table. And then he gave him pencils and pen, and we had one conversation with him and another scientific conversation. We were looking at the response to comments, so he was doing it parallelly, one end with my six-month-old son, and on the other hand with both of us, while we were writing the comments. In fact, I used to have a fear for public speaking. So I used to say, sir, how do you speak? Whatever topic you're able to speak so well. So he used to say, no, why should you? You have to have knowledge and authority. In fact, what I used to do is, I have a lot of these slides. Previously, it was several slides. So morning, I'd ask Manju to pick up 5-6 slides from that pile of slides that I have. And she'll pick up some 5 or 6. And that is what whatever slides may be, I'll be able to present. So that is the kind of authority and this thing that you should have. So, it has been, he was always there for us. Right now, even till now, I think most recent is when we actually had asked him to also work on the National Fellowship with us. He was a jury member for us in selecting the award winners just, last week, and he just wrote us a mail. Whatever problem and whatever we could always go to him, he was being very, very instrumental in this growth of REACH. And I think after his retirement, we always used to, we had several events and we used to call both sir and his wife, Mrs. Lakshmi. And for us, we see both of them as one part of a whole. They were like a unit, such a delightful couple, and just bringing joy just by their presence. And that is what we remember now, because last 6 years, though we know him as director of the institute, the last 6 years when we've been meeting them so often in other platforms, both of them usually together, we remember them as one part of a whole. And that is a memory which I think all of us will keep to our heart. And I think if all of us, as young professionals, if even 1% of what he was, if he could imbibe it in us, I think we'll consider ourselves as extremely good human being.
Thank you, Dr. Ramya. Dr. Ramya is a senior epidemiologist at TBD. Thank you again. Next we'll have Dr. R. Ramakrishnan, a senior scientist and head of division, Department of Statistics.
Thank you, Mr. Srikant. We at National Institute of Epidemiology were really privileged to have Dr. Kumar Swami as our director in charge for 2+ years. Professor Martin is sitting here, he knows that we started the Master of Applied Epidemiology course at NAE in 2001, and we were doing it fairly well till 2005-6. Only in 2008 we wanted to rather change that to Master of Public Health. And that was the time Dr. Gupta also retired and Dr. Kumar Swami took over as the acting in charge. Honestly, we at NAE were really scared to launch MBH program, because MBH is really, you know, it's a different ball game, and we didn't know how to rather go about. But the kind of leadership that was provided by Dr. Kumar Swami was amazing. We had almost every day marathon sessions, right from finalization of the curricula, identification, identifying the resource persons, identifying the course director. Everything was rather done in such a manner. He put a lot of confidence in us, and you know, this aspect of Dr. Kumar Swami, his contribution to the ICMR School of Public Health, I would rather really like to put on records that it was enormous, and you know, he made this MPH course a successful course. It's still running at NAE. Professor Tyagarajan was quoting a few Tirukkurals, and one of the Tirukkural I could rather consider he as an example for it is Irukkan Burangal Nagadar. See, he was managing two institutes, a lot of stress, but I think he bet the stress through humor. That, you know, that was a quality, you know, with which he was able to manage. And but this Irukkan is too much for us to laugh at. And I think, you know, the time of it should heal us from this. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And now we'll have Dr. Jawaharlal to say a few words.
Often we use this phrase, friend, philosopher, and guide, without giving much thought what it means. I think as far as my relationship with Kumar Swami goes, this phrase embodies the relationship between us. As a friend, we go back beyond medical college. We joined EUC together in 1966. And we did a year of BSc because we couldn't get into medical college first year. Then we joined MBBS and we did first year MBBS at the same college in Vaishnav. Then in Stanley. Then we joined for MD again the same year under our revered professor, Dr. Professor Trivandrum, completed MD. And then ICMR, we joined a couple of years earlier because he was a talents scholar. Since then, I've been a step or two behind him, but there's been a remarkable parallelism between our two careers, even in our family life. So as a friend, apart from, I think, with such eminent speakers who have talked all about his academic achievements, one factor that we shared was our sense of proportion of how to value things, not to take things in life too seriously. And of course, you heard about our sense of humor. Dr. Swami has stole my thunder by talking about this presentation made for an April Fool's Day. But he also made some spoofs presentations and TRC. And I think that part of it runs in the family because Ravi, who is here, shares many of those characters with his friend. Dr. Radhakshan, sir, you talk about a woman behind every successful man. Actually, we tested that hypothesis in a study and we published in the Journal of Irreproducible Research. So I can give the reference to anyone who wants to read it. So what I'm trying to say, Kumar Swami, apart from his all his academic achievements, was a man who was full of life, with a great sense of humor. And I'm glad that I have been part of that. Dr. Martin, sir, you talked about immortality, and I agree with you. Apart from the concept of that, you know, that he spread his knowledge to so many others, and I think I have evidence for that can provide for that because that evidence is sitting in front of me today. Kumar Swami was a technical wizard. So if he had not been a doctor, I'm sure he would have been a terrific engineer. With all gadgets, he was like a kid with a new toy, and his children indulged him, I think, very, very often by giving him the latest gadgets. So whenever we have problems with the computer or a small phone, I used to call him and used to sort it out within a day or two by Googling and by searching, and he always had the answer. And there was once when I got my very ordinary smartphone and I couldn't connect to the net to that. And as usual, I approached him and he talked about it for 2 days and he couldn't sort it out. And he said, please come over, we'll talk to my son. And so we connected with Samir across the oceans, and in 3 hours' time we had the answer. So I think the genes have already passed on to his son here and his beautiful daughter. And he leaves behind a fantastic family, very close-knit. And that's been the strength that has helped them to cope with this. Yesterday was the 5th anniversary of the tsunami which hit Japan. A week ago, a sort of tsunami hit us also. And I was wondering how the hell we are going to cope with this. The fact that we are sitting here and talking about such a wonderful human being, I think shows that how this family has been coping. And finally, purposely, I think if you were to ask Kumarasamy how you would have liked to go, I think probably he would have chosen this method. It was quick, it was clinical, it was without pain. And he took with him two of the most important people in his life. So when Ravi and his other brothers were talking about it, they were telling him he just couldn't have been able to cope with one of them that survived. So maybe, in spite of all the tragedy, maybe this was probably the best way to go. Today our thoughts are with this wonderful human being, and we pray that God will give the strength to his family, of Kumarasamy, his wife and his mother, and also the driver who had the complete trust of this Kumarasamy over many years.
Thank you, Dr. Jawal. I request Dr. Arumindu Raja, head of Department of Immunology at NIRT, to say a few words.
Joined the earthquake TRC around the same year along with me, with 1 or 2 years difference. He joined in I joined in a scheme on filariasis, and he was getting the one-man department called clinical immunology. I did my PhD on filariasis, and Dr. Kumarasamy was mainly responsible for all the sample collection from GH. He has helped me a lot in my thesis writing, and correction for which I will always be thankful to him. Without his help, without his help, my thesis would not have been a reality, and I owe my immense thanks to him. Later on, the filariasis project was closed, and he became the member of the Department of Immunology, where he remained in various capacities till he retired. I have interacted with him for about more than 25 years to 30 years. Later on, he joined the immunology family and headed the team and took up the responsibility of the DIC, TRC. I have been observing him from the days when he used to travel to TRC in his Luna, later his Dynamic Honda, and his Maruti car, and later finally in the Dynamic car. So, through all these years, there are certain qualities associated with him permanently. A well-known aspect of his personality is his excellent capacity to write, to present, and his English language skills are impeccable. The best part is that he made us all benefit by his skills. Even for a routine letter to ICMR, he used to scrutinize, tell us, change the letter in a better manner, commenting that this is the language which the administrative people will understand. The content is the same, but now it is it has taken a newer shape. He has polished our oral presentations and even spent time in correcting the students' PhD cases. He voluntarily used to come forward for any effort on official and personal help. Every day I have seen a crowd thronging around his room seeking medical help and advice. He never hesitated to help anybody at the time of need, for which there are numerous examples in my own official and personal life. Not only he is jovial, he is quite serious in shouldering the responsibilities and driving others forcefully to achieve the results. He is quick in his decisions and at the same time very thoughtful and foresighted. He used to advise appropriately. Many a time I have rushed to him in a hurry and with my half-baked decisions he quickly judges and patiently explains the flaws in the plan. Then only it becomes evident to me how all-encompassing and far-reaching his ideas are. The first and foremost is his quick-wittedness and a sense of humor. And his sense of humor, already people have talked about the HIV strain which he developed. The other well-known aspect of his personality is his excellent capacity to write, to present, and his English language skills. The best part is he made us all benefit with his skills. Even for a routine letter to SMR, he used to scrutinize, as I mentioned before. We all know him as a happy, joyful person, always cracking jokes and making his surroundings lively. He has artistic talents too. For such a person, the tragic death is unimaginable and unbelievable. It will take a long time for NIRP family to come out of his memories, especially for those who have close association, close interaction with him. I pray to Almighty that his soul should rest in peace, and I give my heartfelt condolence to the bereaved family. All good things must end someday. I will miss you, sir. We will all miss you, sir.
Now we have Dr. Uma Devi, head of the Department of Bacteriology at NIRP.
Dr. Kumar Swami, our AIDS Director in Charge and Petroleum Department of Immunology. I would refer to him as an eminent personality, a walking encyclopedia, an administrative wizard, a great problem solver, on top of everything, a down-to-earth person with a lot of sense of humor. It was a great honor to be associated with Dr. VK, as we all fondly call him, since my PhD days as a student in the immunology division and then in the then TRC, and had the opportunity of his continued mentorship during my days abroad and after taking up my present position as head of the Department of Bacteriology back at NIRP. Dr. VK, as we all know, is a very dynamic and cheerful person and spreads his magical enthusiasm and goodwill wherever he goes. He is always a great delight to hear his bright and cheerful voice greeting us in his own favorite way of using sirs and madams and leaving us with the feeling that we were the great VIPs and that he is here for us. He is a very thoughtful person and, as I had already mentioned, a great problem solver. When anybody approaches him with this or great issues, he had always given the needed guidance and help and does this with so much ease and confidence that it lightens the burden of the other person, but silently does his own groundwork to provide the necessary help and support to solve their problem. An incident that I should relate here regarding his crystal clear memory is that this happened in 1995. When I was a student here, he had a brief meeting with my father for the first time, and during the course of their discussion, it was brought to the light that Dr. VK's father was a leading lawyer and was my father's professor at Madras Law College. This was a very brief incident of communication. Later, recently, about 2 months ago, I met Mr. Ravi, who is here with us In a meeting at Delhi, that Dr. Ravi mentioned to me that he is Dr. VK's brother. And on the next day of the meeting, Dr. Ravi came back to say me that he had a chat with Dr. VK over the phone that night, and that Dr. VK had actually remembered about this meeting with my dad earlier and relayed the aforementioned conversation. Imagine this was after 20 years. Such was his memory power, and this also reflected the fondness he had for the people he knows and he puts the details. Whether it was introducing me to a Google scholar during my student days or calling me over the phone during my first postdoctoral period in Paris to make sure that I was safe and comfortably settled there, or promptly providing me testimonials whenever I required for processing my green card, or encouraging me to join my present position as NIRT when I informed that I had got this offer, he had given a special touch of mentorship at various instances in my life for which I am really indebted to him and have no words to express the same. But for want of time, we can go on and on about the numerous instances where he touched the hearts of many in his own unassuming way. It came as a rude shock to me, as it would have been to others, to hear his very sad news on 4th of March. And that was only less than about 16 hours after speaking to our dear Dr. VK. And his call at that time was to help a student for a PhD. I could still hear his voice in my ears, and it is unbelievable for me that he is no more with us. I still keep fretting over the fact that I had only wished him a good night that evening. But why did he give us all of a very unexpected goodbye, along with his beloved wife, Madam Lakshmi, and his loving mother? Probably to lessen the suffering of missing him in the world, a very thoughtful person as always. With his loss, NIRT has lost its very eminent scientist, and the world has lost its key contributor and empathic idealist. We understand this is an irreparable loss to his loving children and his near and dear ones. To lose the three beloved family members, a loss that no amount of comforting words could help. I, on behalf of all the students from NIRT who are placed in various parts of the world and who are unable to make it today to this meeting, and on behalf of the Department of Bacteriology, would like to express our deepest condolence to all his loved ones and pray that the Supreme Power gives them enough strength to bear this enormous loss and carry on with their life. We wish and pray that the departed souls rest in eternal peace and guide their loved ones.
Thank you. We have Mrs. Sudha Ganapati.
Thank you for the opportunity. My mind is clouded with many of the memories of Dr. VK, and at this juncture, I just want to reiterate that he is one of the most charismatic personalities I have ever come across. He was a humane person who would go all out to help others. Sheila Fredericks, who was with him in many of the Pyrolysis projects in GH, often used to say how he helped TRC staff members and their families when they went to GH for medical help. She used to say, I'm quoting her, lift irukko illiyo, naalu maadiyum yeri, mele avangala paathu, avangaloda adharava pesittu, vandhu adha pathi enga kittayum solluvaaru. So that in case if somebody comes and asks me, we can tell them. So that is the, helpful attitude which she had. She says, she often used to say, avaroda manidha abhimanatha marakave mudiyadhu. I think this has been reiterated here over and over again in both English and Tamil. I salute his wife Lakshmi, who has been with him through thick and thin of his life and also accompanied him in the tragic end. When I think of his mother, I am reminded of a Thirukkural. Again, today has been a day of Thirukkural. Indra Purudin Perihuvakum Tan Mahane, Sandron in a Keta Thai. Unmail Permepadavendiver, Thirmali Kamalamalavakal. See, this Kural means a mother who feels more happy when she hears from others that his son is a great man. I am sure Mrs. Kamalamal is hearing all this and feeling very proud of our dear Kumaraswamy. I would just, I take this opportunity to read a few lines from a poignant note written from my colleague Neelochanidhi, which reflects the sentiments of most of us. She says, all of us are still in a state of shock and disbelief at the sudden stroke of a fate so cruel that it not only took away our friend, Dr. Kumaraswamy, but also those of two very precious women in his life in one catastrophic moment. We keep seeking reasons when we know too well there are no answers for some questions in life. She says, I'm just reading a few lines from it. She says, he had a way with his words and most of it were transferred into action. That was Dr. Kumaraswamy. She has specifically mentioned that her heart goes out to the family, especially Manju and Sami, who lost both parents and their grandmother all at once. That was Meenu's tribute. the present and past staff of the Department of Social and Behavioral Sciences, join me in praying for the departed souls and those they have left behind for strength and courage to carry on. Thank you.
Thank you, madam, for the kind words. We have about 15 minutes for those who have not had the opportunity to speak so far to say a few words. So, about 3 minutes for each person, please.
This platform is very helpful. This is the topmost tragedy in the NIRT, or TRC, TCC, TRC, NIRT, because I joined 1958. I met Dr. Kumaraswamy in the Madras Medical College to draw blood for the filarial study, which was asked by Dr. Ramesh. We were doing the filarial study, PhD in the so that I went and met him. As soon as I saw Dr. Kumaraswamy, I shocked him. Such a cute like this, no? I said, sir, you are a doctor. He said, yes. Will you bring the tube? Yes, sir. No. He asked me the first question. I had the anticoagulant is there inside the tube. Yes, sir. Or then give me. Then drop. After that, because of he the student of Philip from the ICFA, he joined in the duty. Then Dr. Tripathi put me, started the immunology department in the 80s. I was the first person who appointed as a technician in immunology with one microscope and one with the computer, incubator. Then more other people I joined. And Dr. Kumaraswamy, because why he took the filarial study, Dr. Neva, when he was in here, Dr. Dupati brought me because one attendant has got the day blood microfilaria was there. Usually night blood only find out. But in TRC, we found one attendant, his name was, I forgot his name, Christopher. In his blood, we found one microfilaria, and I put in the blood slide, and all staff went and saw the, how the microfilaria is moving in the blood. So, that Neva interested told Dr. Paswamy what to start because he found that is the interesting thing. Dr. Neva wanted to start this department. So, the first person I was there in immunology and did everything of these things. From that time, when he joined as a staff member, from that day and the retirement after that, I was for all the technical works in filarial and things, draw blood. 36,000 slides I have screened according to his instruction, given some papers. And we divided, formatted the counting the blood in the microfilaria blood, in 1 ml blood, from 5, 1, 2, 2, 15,000 lives. So many occasions I was with him. He has come to my house with Eric Hodgson. And in that very small cell, Jairaji, do you know how to prepare puri? Because Eric Hodgson wants to see how the puri comes up like this. Immediately I put some flour and made it immediately. Such a kindly, so many things. If I want to talk, maybe half an hour, more than an hour, I can talk with him. But finally, I talked only one I want to say. I used to think when I am small, at the age of 28, I joined in the center. The 58 years I am here with you all, people are the dignity. One chance, because I am moving with the Dr. Kumaraswamy, I happen to move with all high level people, including Professor. I used to hear him, when he want to go everywhere for the meeting and abroad and here, he wants slides, about 5 level slides. All slides, what he has shown to everywhere, then with me only. I was the photographer from that day up to 3 years back up to here. So this is a good opportunity to meet all big eminent promise in the lifetime. This is a very good thing. But one thing I used to think, from small person to the high level person, people are growing. But because of Kumaraswamy's life, I followed it. Oh, this is the way all people come up from the small up to high level. So that kind of the example for Dr. Kumaraswamy. But this is a very, very topmost tragedy. Can't believe this. But I pray to the God, his three people's rest in peace. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
It's very hard to speak on this occasion. But I want to say a few things which were not said by others. I think he was with us for almost 3 years at NIE. And it was a very crucial time for our organization. We were going through a lot of transition. And many of us are very young there. I think, as you know, that our age pyramid was slightly different, and all of us who were involved in the MPH program were very young and had very little experience. But he trusted us and he believed in us. And he always said, you can do it. He'll just say and he'll walk away. And then we wondered, maybe we can do it. He always made us feel that you are not young. If you want to do something, you can do. I think that's something I'm sure his kids must have also learned from him. But I think another thing which I want to say, which nobody else has talked about, is I think his gender sensitivity. He was so understanding. When I worked with him, my son was very small, almost same as his granddaughter's age. And his most conversations with me were, how is your son doing? He always asked me. And he shared his experience. You know, my granddaughter does this. Does your son do that? Okay, so we would be talking like parents. He will be talking like a parent. Oh, you know what? My daughter is like getting so worked up sometimes. You girls need to chill out. Just relax. Don't worry. And he'll always tell me, no, sister, I can't attend this meeting. I can't go for... Just take care of your child. Just take care of your child. He was very understanding. I think another very great thing about him, which nobody said, was his sense of detachment. I think people achieve and they get so attached to it. You know, they feel, they want to hold on to it. But he was a person who was very detached. And it was evident in the way he went about doing so many things. And I just want to say one thing. When he took his retirement and we asked him, sir, we really are going to miss you. And he said, what is there? We should go. When people are asking, why are you going? We should not go. When people start asking, why are you not going? And you know, that was a very deep statement. Very, very deep. And we know that people like to hold on. But he always let it go. And I think if you would have asked him how he would like to go from this world, probably this is the way he would have liked to go. I've been thinking about it ever since that day. And if I would have asked him, he would have laughed and said, this is the best way for me to go. I have my wife with me, I have my mother. And still people remember me. Maybe if I'm too old, disabled, nobody will remember me that I existed. So I think as we hold his memories in our heart, he was an inspiration to all of us youngsters. We can never forget him. And we hope that we could be, as Ramya said, even 1% of what he was. That would be a great achievement.
Let me introduce myself because I may be new to this ICMR group. Though I am a friend of Dr. V. Kumar Swami from 1978, when he was a postgraduate under Professor K. Vithirangalam. I was a senior also at that time. So from that time, we know each other. Then he became a scientist. I became a plastic surgeon. But still, I continued to work in Madras Medical College. And we used to operate on these lymphatic filariasis patients. So we had ward number 51 as our study room where we conduct a lot of drug trials. And then we used to operate on all those patients which have got grade 4 lymphedema. And he is the first scientist, as I say, who put the clinicians, or the rather the surgeons and the scientists together. So he said, why not we start an association where the scientists interact with the clinicians like me. So we started the Lymphology Society of India. He was the treasurer of that association, and he continued to be till his end the same post. And he was the president because we told him, though this is your brainchild, Lymphology Society of India, being a treasurer, of course, is a wonderful job. Maintaining the money is an important thing for all of us. But we would like you to be a president for a period of 2 years. So he was a president for the Lymphology Society of India. And he put us again into the International Society of Lymphology. He brought the scientific group with Eric Artisan from WHO. And all of us with clinicians. So he is very instrumental in most of the things. And above all, though, as I said, I'm in a different corporate hospital, working in the corporate group, but he never left us. why not we do research with the corporate hospital? So we have published many publications with Dr. Kumar Sami, where the secondary infection is responsible for the progress of the lymphatic filariasis disease rather than the filariasis per se. So that paper was published by us. After that, we have published a few things. I am Dr. Manoharan, I am a plastic surgeon with Apollo Hospital. So I just thought his contribution is not only with the scientific community or with the governmental institution. He is very much with the, wherever people are interested, whether it is private hospitals, corporate hospitals, he is there. He will come to Apollo Hospital and he will guide us to do what are the things to be done. And we have sent our juniors to him and he trained with the Center of Excellence here. So he is always a man who is willing to help, willing to take part. He never said to me, I also used to ask him, how come you are an in-charge director for both the institutions and you have to travel such a long distance? He never, no alternate day, I just travel and come. So he take things very lightly and very, when you look at him, nothing is stressful. He will always behave in such a way. Nothing gave him any stress, anything. He will simply say, no, this is not a problem, we will do it. And apart from that, as a human being, he always helps. When I lost my wife, and I have only one daughter, so when I said, I don't know how to go about searching for an alliance, then he took me to a place where to register for matrimonial services, and he helped me even as a personal. So he is such a kind of simple person. He finds time for even those things. That and all is not necessary. Even your close friend won't do. But because I am alone and I need help, he came forward to help me. So I really, till now, I am not able to come to terms that we have lost Dr. Kumar Sami. But I have to pray to God that give great courage to the children, both of them. I know them from their small kid, and I pray to God for all the three souls to rest in peace.
Thank you. Request Dr. Ravi, please say a few.
Good afternoon. It's going to be tough. He meant, he was fondly known as Chinna in my family. My mother lost the first child. So he was the second. She was very protective, very possessive. So possessive that when he got the first rank in Jipmer, she wouldn't let him go 160 kilometers from Chennai. The beneficiary was Ravi Rangachar. Ravi became a very dear friend to the family. There are many things that people do not know Kumar Sami. A very fine artist. I don't know how many of you have seen his paintings. He won the national collage competition. He was like Jawahar to me, very dear friend. Never brothered me, but fathered me. Shaped my career. I think we should celebrate his life. Thank you for this great opportunity.
Thank you, Dr. Ravi. Your request, Sami, Dr. Kumar Sami, sir, to say a few words.
Thanks for it, all of you, for being such a great orator. So, I think at least 100th of how good he was. I think I've done a pretty good job. I knew my dad only at a personal level. Not as a great scientist, but I think towards the recent few days, there's somebody who can replace me as a security engineer in California. He was that good in technology. His passion towards reading is something that he inculcated in my sister and myself. And what I wanted to talk about was just three things that I think I learned from him, but I never had the opportunity to express. And it was It is very humbling to be in the midst of people who probably have known him before my birth. And at a place where we made fun of that it is his second home, and a place that my mom said you should probably be married to, and a place that my grandmother just knew as TRC. The three things that my dad taught me was that you need to work hard, nothing comes for free, and he did that by working hard for me. As I sit here with my sister and brother-in-law and my wife, the reason I am here today is because of his hard work, not mine. And that's something that I will take with me. Just as an example, he was at WHO in Delhi, and my college bus used to come at 6:20 in the morning to pick me up. He used to call me daily in the morning to make sure I was up, even before I got up. It's the kind of hard work he put in. The second thing that he taught me was selflessness. He would never, ever, ever, ever buy something for himself without providing for his family. Be it a pair of slippers, or a nail cutter, or a new shirt, or some of the tech gadgets that I thankfully was able to get him towards here. The third thing that he taught me was family. My dad had an extremely interesting concept of work-life balance. Somebody mentioned, he used to bring the slides home, ask Manju and me to pick them up and make it a play routine, but still working at the same time. It is difficult for him to be without my mother, and I think what has happened is, as many people mentioned, maybe it was how it was meant to be. He was always proud of his two granddaughters. Both of them are here. And it was I think it was his happiest days when he saw them grow up. He will always be my role model, as maybe he was for several people. I never got the opportunity to tell him. He was my greatest strength. And if I am what I am today, it was because of him. Thank you.
Thank you, Savich. Now, I request Manju, Dr. Kumar Savich's daughter, to say a few words.
Good afternoon. I never really thought I would ever have to do this. And even if I stood here forever, I would never be able to describe what I have to say about my mother and my father. I was raised by extraordinary parents, and they meant the world to me. My dad spoiled me silly. My mom was my guiding force. And like Samir said, if I am here today, it's because of them. I owe all that I am to my mother Lakshmi and my father Kumaraswamy. Their greatest joy I have seen are in my children. And I think that was the only thing I could do for them. He was extremely proud, and so was my mom. They were extremely proud of Ashrita and Adira. And I'm sure they were proud peacocks showing them off to all of you. their every milestone, their every moment. Whether nice or naughty, they were very proud of them. I had never seen my dad watch TV, but for the first time, he used to tell Sam off when he used to watch Scooby-Doo, but for the first time, I saw him sit down and watch all the Disney shows with her, actually learn who is Taylor Swift, Katy Perry, research about Pokemon cards, Beyblades. Even in fact, when she used to practice the violin, I've never seen my dad do that for us. He would hold the violin notes for her, even though she had a stand, and she would just play, and she could just order him about. My mother and father made an exceptional team, and if there was one takeaway I could get from their wonderful life together, would be to support each other through every circumstance, to stand up for each other, to be loving, to be kind, to never expect anything in return, but give, give, and give unconditionally. Amma and Nana, I'm really proud to be your daughter. And I hope at some point I did something to make you proud too. I miss you and I love you. And I know that every decision that I will have to make in my life, it'll always come back to one simple question. What would Nana do? What would Amma do? You have been the source of my convictions. You have been my inspiration. I am just not proud, but I am privileged to have been your daughter. I love you forever. Thank you. This is my older daughter Ashrita, and Chintu and Amma, as she called my parents, were her true love, as she declared one day. And she would like to say something about them. She's written a small poem, and she would like to read it out for all of you. And I don't think my dad and mom would have liked to end this on any other note but to hear from their dearest granddaughter.
Chintu and Amma are so awesome. They watch me grow and help me blossom. When I am stuck, they help me with things. They put me to sleep with stories and singing. They cheer me up when I am down, for they cannot see me from. Chintu helps me with words I can't pronounce. You're the bestest girl, Amma will announce. Chintu and Amma make me laugh, sing, and twirl. They are the bestest grandparents.
the end of the program. Thank you, one and all, for attending the program.